The word peri in Greek means around, and the word coron is derived from corona, which is a Latin word for crown. An itis is a common suffix in medical terminology indicating inflammation. So when putting it all together, pericoronitis is an inflammation around the crown of a partially erupted tooth. When a wisdom tooth is unable to fully emerge or align correctly due to spatial constraints, it becomes impacted or partially erupted. This partial eruption often results in a flap of gum tissue called the operculum that covers a portion of the tooth. The operculum can trap food particles and bacteria, creating a haven for bacterial growth and setting the stage for infection and inflammation. Pericoronitis presents distinct signs such as redness, swelling, especially near the operculum, and persistent pain. If the infection worsens, symptoms develop into bad breath, difficulty opening the mouth, swollen lymph nodes, and occasionally a mild fever. Pericoronitis commonly affects younger adults when wisdom teeth emerge. The condition is aggravated by poor oral hygiene, crowded teeth, and sugar-heavy diets, or promoting bacterial growth around the partially erupted tooth. Diagnosing pericoronitis relies on the dentist performing a comprehensive clinical examination of the oral cavity, paying special attention to areas around a partially erupted or impacted tooth. Inflammation, swelling, and signs like pus or an operculum often point directly to the condition. A periapical and a panoramic x-ray might be used to get a clearer view of the tooth's position to rule out other pathologies. In managing pericoronitis, a spectrum of approaches is adopted. Non-surgical methods including regular brushing, flossing, and using antiseptic mouthwashes to remove the symptoms. Pain is often addressed with over-the-counter pain medications, and in cases of severe infections, antibiotics might be prescribed. Irrigation of the affected area with saline or chlorhexidine solution is often recommended to alleviate discomfort and some of the infectious load. These non-surgical methods may not fully resolve pericoronitis, as the operculum can still trap food and bacteria. Thus, these are temporary solutions pending definitive treatments. The definitive treatments include surgical interventions, primarily extracting the problematic tooth, and if not possible, then removing the operculum is another option. To summarize, pericoronitis is an inflammation often accompanying the emergence of a wisdom tooth. The main instigator is the operculum, a gum flap that traps debris and bacteria. Signs and symptoms include redness, pain, halitosis, sometimes difficulty opening the mouth, with swelling and fever. The diagnosis leans on clinical examination and radiography. Addressing the condition usually involves good hygiene practices, pain management, and surgical interventions.